Assalamu alaikum and hi everyone, this is AWP Gaurika bringing you yet another amazing video. This time I decided to make something different for you guys. So today I'm traveling to Kut Sharif, which is about 55 kilometers from the city of Bahawalpur. It's known as the city of saints. It's a very old city, has a rich history, rich background to it. A lot of conquerors, a lot of Muslim, you know, fighters come to this area and played their part in the rich cultural and historical background that the city has. I'm going to take you there. We're going to go to Kut Sharif today, drive there, see the views, the beautiful roads along the way. I've heard there are a lot of date palms, date trees. There are beautiful views along the way. The desert ecosystem unfolds itself as we travel towards Kut Sharif. Let's take you there without any further waiting to do. If you're new to the channel, please do subscribe, leave a like, hit that bell notification icon so that you don't miss out on any of the good stuff. So let's take you straight into the video without any further waiting to do. Ladies and gentlemen, this is the first time actually I'm including historical sites. No, this is not the first time I'm including historical sites. This is the first time I'm including religious sites of Pakistan in my travel vlogs. I heard a lot about Kut Sharif. It's a really rich and cultural place with a history that dates back to pre-Christ days. Pre-Christ just means before the days Hathisa was born. It dates back to Alexander the Great. It was back in 325 BCE. That this city came in limelight. A lot of historians say that Alexander the Great laid the foundations of Alexandria over here. And some archaeologists even say that its history dates back even before Alexander. So it was around somewhere around 500 BCE. Then it was taken over by the Muslims in 712 by Muhammad bin Qasim. Then in the 10th or 11th centuries by Mahmud Ghazni. Later on, it was controlled basically by the Delhi Sultanate, and off and on, its control went from the hands of Delhi Sultanate to the Mughals. Humayun tried to capture it. Later on, Akbar also tried to lay his hands on Urch, and it came under its control, under the control of the Mughals. Afterwards, there was a lot of infighting. The British came, so it remained. As part of state of Bahawalpur and was controlled by the Nawabs of Bahawalpur. However, it takes its lineage, the Islamic lineage from Multan, from the great Sufi saint Bahauddin Zikriya. So there are a set of tombs and historic sites in Kut Sharif which I am planning to visit today. They include four major shrines. One is of Jalaluddin Bukhari. Came from Bukhara, was a Muslim cleric, Muslim saint. Drew inspiration from Bahauddin Zikriya, his great-granddaughter, Bibi Javindi. The architect who designed the tomb, known as Noria. Let's get there and see what we find. The journey is about 80 kilometers. Let's see what we find over there. I finally reached Kut Sharif. These roads are crisscrossing the town. I mean, not a very good or excellent road takes you there. So I'm taking the route from in between or wherever my GPS is telling me to go. The journey was pretty fine. The roads are good, but inside, once you reach Kut Sharif and once you're trying to approach the main tombs, the roads are not that pretty or that good. Let's reach there and learn about Urch. There are mango trees, there are orchards around it. You can see there are beautiful date trees and dates on them right now. Imagine, this is the first time I'm looking at pure date trees, jisko khajur ka darakht kehte hain. Beautiful and amazing. And ladies and gentlemen, there it is. That's the rare side of the Bibi Javindi's Mazar. The roads are pretty rustic and dusty and they're being built right now. So behind me, you can see two tombs over there. This is the rare side of the complex. There are three over there, and on the sidelines there is Hazrat Jalaluddin Bukhari. So let's get there and get a few B-roll shots and see what this thing is made of.
Park my vehicle somewhere around there, got the token. I'm moving up towards B.P. Chavindi's mausoleum, which is the most famous mausoleum around here. I'm gonna move there. Oh my god, I gotta set my eyes, so. Alright. Sorry for the continuous brightness adjustments around here. I'm gonna adjust them according to the light. There was less light, so I boosted up my ISO a bit. We are nearing the mazar over here. I'm gonna take a few shots of this amazing piece of structure and show you how it looks from here. So I've reached the main entrance gate for the Bibi Javindi's mazar. As you can see right behind me, that huge mega structure is basically that mazar. Let's get inside and I'm gonna show you. I'm gonna tell you a little bit of history about it, and we're gonna see it from inside. It's basically damaged because of floods in the 18th or 19th, early parts of the 18th century. Let's see what it is. Oh my god, it's damn hot around here. I've walked and reached Bibi Javindi's mazar. I'm gonna tell you a little bit about it. Really a respectable place, really a place to, you know, be humble. So let's get a few B-roll shots and see what this piece of structure has to offer to us. Alright guys, the tomb in which I'm standing right now is of Bibi Javindi. Now this particular tomb was constructed back in 1493 by an Iranian prince by the name of Dilshad. It's a beautiful piece of architecture. The outer structure is octagonal in shape, whereas inside the walls are angled in such a manner that it seems round. Half of this structure, as you can see, half of it was lost in floods back in the 18th or 19th century. There was a massive flood, so it destroyed half of the tomb over here. Right now, reconstruction work is going on. The government is putting in some efforts. As you can see, this whole architectural piece that is remaining is also quite beautiful. That's it for the tomb of Bibi Javindi. Now we're going to go visit the tomb of Ustad Nooria and Bahawal Ali's tomb. So let's get there. Alright guys, so this amazing piece behind me is the tomb of Bahawal Ali. He was the great grandson of Jalaluddin Bukhari. So this is also a masterpiece of architecture over here. Can you imagine the third tomb is of the engineer or architect that was sent by Prince Dilshad from Khorasan, at that time the ruler of Iran. And that third one has basically been constructed in honor of the engineer known by the name of Nooria, who was also a Sayyid. So let's take a look at this monument and see what it's made of. So ladies and gentlemen, guys and girls, this was the tomb of Hazrat Bahawal Ali, the grandson of Jalaluddin Bukhari. Right now moving towards Nooria's tomb, just so in honor of his designing skills and his effort to raise these two mega structures up, this is the structure that was built in his honor. Beautiful, isn't it? All of the three structures over here are super amazing. Really loved the details. I'm sweating like hell. It's really pretty hot. All of these three structures and three areas of interest that I had marked for myself to see must have been architectural marvels of their time. It must have taken a lot of effort by the engineers in those days, or the architects, or anybody who was here and building these structures from ground up. A lot of effort must have gone into it. This is Nawab Bahawal's tomb, and the one behind me, that's the one of Bibi Javindi, and the last but not least, the Nooria, the architect also has a place over here. This is a very, very important religious site for one of the sects of Islam. Now, beautiful structure over here. The air is mesmerizing. There is a lot of serenity in here. There is a sense of calm. The locals come over here, they practice some traditions, make dua, they pray, and it's a wonderful place to be, wonderful place to visit, wonderful place to see. Look at the magnificence of Bibi Jawindi's structure over there. It's truly amazing how the engineers back in those days could design something of this magnitude and this opacity and opulence and exuberance. Pretty amazing, guys. So for this vlog over here, this is it for today. I know it's a short vlog. I'll be getting some more good stuff for you guys in the future. If you guys are new to the channel, please do leave a like, do subscribe, and turn on those bell notification icons so that you don't miss out on any of the good stuff. Oh, ladies and gentlemen, guys and girls, this is AWP Exotica signing off from Mush Sharif. It's really hot. I need to get back to my home at Bahawalpur. See you guys in another travel vlog. See you guys very soon. Bye-bye.